Hello, today I'm going to show you how to do textured bark on a tree. We've done birch trees before, but people have been asking me about how to do this one. So that's the one I'm going to attempt right now. Hopefully it looks something like this. So I'm going to set it aside, and I've got a piece that I've already got ready. I've got the sky and the foreground in there, and that was just dropping some colors in and blowing them with compressed air. In the top here, I've got for this sky color, I've got stonewashed and sailboat blue, and just drop some blender and let it flow around and blow it. And in the foreground, I've got just some greens. I've got meadow and lettuce, a little bit of caramel in there. So pretty simple background. And okay, let's get started with that big tree. So for the base color, I've got espresso and teakwood, and I'm just using a liner brush and then paint it in right on top of what I have here. So just get my couple smaller branches in. Come this way a little bit. These are going to be nice thick branches leading down to the trunk. And I'm going to bring it just about to the ground, to the bottom edge of the tile, but not quite. And it'll be a little bit of roots coming out. I'm going to start thickening up this side. And maybe this one's going to come up over here and split that way. And you could use different shades of brown if you want, but espresso and teakwood are the darkest ones. And I'm going to pull the bottom out a little bit here. And you can see as I go over those dark lines in the background, the ink will just push right through. And pull it down this way a little bit. And I'm going to thicken up this main part. It's the big old kind of tree you like to climb when you were kids. Some are crossing from behind, some are crossing in front. But I want this to be pretty dark so that when I bring in my bark, you'll really catch the highlight of the texture. Join that one up to this one here. Let's see. I'm looking at my one that I already have done here, just so I'm not wasting too much time trying to figure this out. And you can even see it making some texture already just by mixing with the colors that are behind there. And I'll make one coming off the side. And one of the main things about making branches look how they really are is that it will never go skinny to wide. It'll always, as it tapers away from the tree, it'll always get smaller. It'll never get fatter. So if it's too fat up here, you have to widen it down here. Okay, let's see. Maybe I'll branch this one off up here. And like I said, they can cross over. I'm going to make this one go in front. So I pull enough through here. You'll see that it looks like it's in front. Now those are the main thicker branches. So now I'm going to just put in a few smaller ones. Okay, so let's go this way. Branch some off over here. And I like to go right off the edge of the tile. But if you want to stop them before that, you can. More. Now you could twist some a little bit too here. They don't all have to be straight. Just a little bit more, and then we're going to go to even tinier branches. Okay, I think we just about got her. A little bit thicker over here. Okay. So that's your main branches. Now I'm going to go in with some smaller branches and use a Sharpie. That one looks pretty good. So as long as it's dry, you can get away with. I should have gave it. I'm going to give it a quick blow with the air here, just to make sure it's good and dry. And that's canned air, same kind you use for blowing out your keyboards. Okay, I'll try this one. Okay, now it should be good and dry. Yeah, it is now. You can always tell if the ink isn't going on very well, then it might be a little bit wet. So I'm just going to pull off a whole bunch of small branches here. Like I said, some can be squiggly, some will be straight. That branch ash looks a little too pale for me, so I'm going to darken it up a bit through the side here. Okay, now I'm going to go to my Micron micro pen. The line is just a little bit finer than this previous pen that I used. So, make some even finer. Maybe I'll make a couple coming off down here. Okay, now I'm going to use my dental tools to get some texture and get some nice bark in there. So I gotta get a clean little tray here. And I'm gonna start off with just a little bit of blending solution. I guess you can use alcohol too, it doesn't matter. So I'm tapping my micro brush into here and tapping it on the paper because I don't want it to be soaking wet. And I'm going to just catching the light on the bark on one side more than the other side. We want one part of the tree in shadow and one part in the light. And you can really see the nice texture we're getting here. Go down this one. A little bit down there. Okay, now up the side, a little bit over into this one. And then I'm going to go up to this one a little bit. And I'm just pushing hard enough that it's pushing through the ink a little bit. And some of that white of the tile is coming through. But you always have to be careful that it's not really wet, really soaked, because then you'll have a great big bubble and you won't be happy. Okay, so I'm jumping over that branch and I'm coming up this side a little bit. Up into here. And it's time for a clean one here. And if it gets away on you too much, if it's making too big of a wet spot, just blow on it. And that should stop it from getting away. Okay, now we're going to go over here a little bit. Just catching some highlights there from the sun, showing the texture. And you could also use a different color to do the same thing. Here, I'll take some caramel, which is a lighter brown. And add some other colors in there.
bring it a little bit up here. Oops, dropping everything. Now, if there's any parts I want to darken up, I'm just going to reach over here. Excuse me. Grab my black. Sorry about that. Okay, this is pitch black. And if you want to darken a little bit on the shadowed side, black works well. And you can also throw in some more branches with the black too if you like. Okay. So I think I've got most of my texture in there. Try a little bit more. Lighten this one up a little bit. A little bit up there. Okay, I think that's good. Now I'm going to just add a little bit of leaves into the trees. It's kind of a fall time picture, but there might still be some leaves up in the top. So this is my stamper with felt on there, and that was lettuce. So first dab it on the paper so you don't have too much blobby leaves there. Up there. That was lettuce. Maybe I'll switch to meadow, which is a bit of a darker color. Okay, now I'm going to go in with some honeycomb because, like I said, it's fall time, so the leaves are turning color a little bit. Okay. And maybe a few leaves around the bottom, just on the ground, somewhere on the ground here. And just going to drag some of those branches down into the ground a bit more here. Oh, wasn't quite dry, but I'll try my other one here. Oops. That's the wrong one. There it is. Few more squiggly branches coming through. Okay. I think we're just about done here. That's about all I'm going to do. And sign the corner. There we go. And that's
That's how you do bark.
And I will post in the comments the link for these micro brushes. I get a lot of people asking, so I'll post that in the comments after I get it loaded.
Well done. Thanks a lot.